Brandon, thank you very much for having us here in beautiful Rhode Island. We just drove this afternoon the S63 AMG, the S Coupe, and it's, out of this world.
It is, isn't it?
The S50, the S550 is like already amazing, but then you add up like so many things. It's like almost like a different car.
It is, isn't it? So, and that's really what it is. So we at AMG, we take what's already near perfection, right? The S550 Coupe, and we say that car is phenomenal. It's a great touring car. It's a great luxury car. But for a customer who wants to be a little bit sportier, a little bit more aggressive, that's where we come in.
A lot more aggressive.
A lot more aggressive, exactly. Is fair.
Well, it's great. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I mean, it's just like so fabulous. It's like, again, like the S550, you accelerate, you turn on that engine, you hear like, ooh, like, sounds good. But yeah. Then you turn the other one, it's like another level.
It is, absolutely. You know, a lot of people think at first that the AMG is just a high horsepower Mercedes, and it's really not. So, yes, it has more horsepower, but really we go in and completely re-engineer the vehicle. So the entire drivetrain, the suspension, the transmission, the engine, the brakes, even the weight distribution of the vehicle, we go in and change and optimize for performance.
Yeah, and also the engines are like individually built, so there's like... There you go, like to the old ways almost of doing things, like really one person specialized in one thing.
Absolutely. So AMG, we're celebrating 47 years, and our philosophy is one man, one engine. So we literally take from the cast engine block, one person is the same exact person who screws the very first bolt on that engine to the very last bolt and when we test it. It's so important for us from a quality standpoint, from an engineering standpoint, to abide by that philosophy. And it's really what sets us apart in the marketplace. There's almost nobody else follows that philosophy of one man, one engine. And that's what really gives us the edge and the quality and the craftsmanship. And so you can experience what you did today.
Yeah, absolutely. So going back to the history and all that, I mean, like, it's been 47 years, but like the past recent years, it's been like a huge success for AMG, right? I mean, the numbers are like through the roof.
They absolutely are. So, you know, when Mercedes-Benz took us over and bought us about 11 years ago or so, it really changed the entire landscape and direction of our company in a very, very positive way. And now we look at the past couple of years. I mean, this year, our sales are up 58% year over year.
That's great.
It's insane, isn't it? And the product portfolio we have with the S63 Coupe that we're launching literally 2 days ago that you had the opportunity to drive, and the upcoming all-new AMG GT, and then the C63 and C63S models coming up in the springtime. We just have a huge onslaught of product coming up the next couple of years.
Yeah, all the way down to the GLA, which is like the entry-level SUV now. That was fantastic. I really enjoyed that. And again, it's the same experience. When you get into the regular car, it's like a great experience, but then like completely changes the car, right? Everything in it.
Yeah, I mean, and the GLA is really the second of a 1-2 punch for us, right? So we launched the CLA 45 last year with great success. CLA 45, to this day, we still have over a 70% conquest rate on that vehicle. So we're really attracting all new buyers to the Mercedes AMG brand, Mercedes-Benz brand for the 250s. The GLA is just the second part of that same storyline, right? So for that customer that wants a little bit more utilitarian vehicle, maybe something that's a little bit more comfortable to drive down the road, but they still want that fun, sporty feel, GLA 45, it's a knockout car.
Yeah. Going back to the S Coupe AMG, obviously it's a very exclusive market, and like low-volume car, but like still it's a great value for what it is.
It really is. And it's kind of funny when you're talking about, you know, an S63, which starts at a little over $160,000, to say it's a great value.
Yeah.
But when you look at what the competition is and what you can also buy at a similar price point or for even more money, you look at what we get in this car with the standard features, with the intelligent drive systems, the CPA systems, our collision prevention assist, our Distronic Plus, our night vision assist, our head-up display. When you look at everything that comes in the vehicle, not to mention the craftsmanship, the quality, the attention to detail that we have, and above all, the styling of the car, it really does represent an incredible value in that segment of the market.
Yeah, probably the most important thing is the technology, because with the support of the whole Daimler Group, Mercedes-Benz, I mean, the technology that you inherited already into the car, the safety technology especially. Mm-hmm. Like today, it was a very rainy day, very hard rain in the morning, and like the lane departure feature, which reads the lines on the road, I couldn't see them almost because it was so hard. But the car was still doing his thing, like correcting me and all that when needed.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was actually speaking to one of your colleagues earlier today, and similarly, you know, we had a moment where it was just torrential downpour, and he could barely see in front of him, and yet the car was slowing down for him because the car could see ahead further than you can with your eyes with the infrared systems and the radar systems that we're using. So it actually slowed the vehicle down before he even knew that he should be slowing down the vehicle.
And there's no other car company that can do that, and that at both ends, like the technology and the performance together.
I think we do a great job marrying the two, right? There's a lot of really great performance vehicles out there, and there's a lot of other manufacturers that are also doing a lot of things when it comes to safety in the vehicles and incorporating technology. But I think Mercedes-Benz really nailed it on this car, right? As you said, it's the perfect balance, and it's the epitome of how do we incorporate technology in the vehicle where it's not obtrusive, where it's still a fun car to drive, right? But at the same time, we're incorporating all of the most advanced safety features available.
Yeah, that's that was my next question. I mean, we're getting to a point in technology. I mean, this car, if you ask me without knowing what it was and everything, I think it's like 60% there like to autonomous driving. I mean, you can drive itself, but it's such a fun car to drive that some people might think, well, maybe too much technology in it, and like I still want to drive it like a regular car.
Yeah. So you could definitely always drive the car, right? So the autonomous driving is always secondary to the driver, right? The driver is never the secondary person in the vehicle. And particularly on the AMG side, it's a driver's vehicle. And we will always be a driver's vehicle, right? But where the autonomous features come into play, right, and the safety features are exactly what you spoke about a little bit earlier. When you're in situations where the vehicle can read and perceive variables that are around the vehicle better than you can because of poor visibility, because of somebody jutting, you know, cutting you off in front of you, that's where the intelligent drive is most important, is those situations that we can't predict, we can't see, or we can't interpret based on what's going on around the vehicle. Because you can't look around the car 360 degrees all the time.
Yeah, all the time.
But the car can, and that's the incredible part.
Yeah, and there's always going to be the human factor, even though, like, I guess whenever, if that time comes ever, like, the cars are going to still be driven on their own, there's going to be a human being inside the car, and maybe you can, like, do something. So the AMG is always driver's cars. So I guess there's some news also like coming up with the new model from Mercedes-Benz with the GT. I think AMG already has confirmed that too.
Yeah, so we just announced a couple weeks ago an all-new pure AMG vehicle. So it's the second vehicle completely engineered and developed solely by AMG, the first being the SLS, which was a phenomenal success. Our next one being the Mercedes AMG GTS. We'll be launching that in the spring, so roughly 6 months away or so. It's been met with phenomenal reviews. The car is so sexy. The lines on it. It really is the epitome of the Mercedes-Benz design philosophy of what modern luxury and sensual purity really are.
Yeah, but contrary to the SLS, which was like a limited production car, this is here to stay, right?
It is here to stay, yeah. So the SLS was we knew from day one, right? The SLS was going to be a supercar that we made. We're going to make it for 7 years, and then we're going to be done with the vehicle and retire it. And that's what we did. We retired the vehicle. We just finished production of the vehicle about 4 months ago. The GT will be a mainstay in the Mercedes-Benz portfolio from this point forward, absolutely.
Yeah. So the SLS adds value to it now because now it's a collector's item.
Exactly, exactly. And the good thing about the GTS is that we're entering a segment of the market that we've never competed in before, right? The SLS was a supercar.
Yeah.
The GT is a phenomenal sports car in a segment that we haven't competed in, so it's going to be really interesting to enter that market and show that what Mercedes and AMG can do together to really attack it.
Yeah, that's kind of surprising to me that for this long time, like, you didn't have that car to compete with your German's competitors. I mean, that was kind of surprising to me, but so it's really good that you finally have that product to do it.
Absolutely. You know, we're always evaluating the market and figuring out where is there a little bit of white space where we're not fulfilling the market and there is a demand for it, right? We don't want to fill space, right? We see some other manufacturers in the market doing that.
Yeah, that defeats the purpose, really.
It defeats the purpose, and you come up with these superfluous vehicles that don't make sense and nobody really needs, right? But when the market demands it and we see an opportunity to take advantage of it, that's when we act.
Well, excellent. I can't wait to drive that one. So we're going to keep enjoying this one for now. But
absolutely.
I can't wait to do that one.
You're going to love it, I promise.
Well, thank you very much, Brandon, for your time, and we'll talk to you soon.
Absolutely. Thank you, Javier.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.